We also want to just give a shout out to Greta Pullen and Katie Trujillo, who have been here with us this whole weekend and have been very helpful in getting us doors unlocked and all the cosas. So thank you. And now to the business at hand. At night, with my wife sitting on the bed, I turn from her to unbuckle my belt so she won't see her father unbuckling his belt. The first time I read this poem by Martin Espada, When the Leather is a Whip, I was sitting in a chair that was falling apart. But though it was falling apart, it was my chair. I had just bought it with what little money I had saved up from a few friends. I had it because I needed a place in my small apartment to sit and write. I didn't have a room, really, or a table, but I did have this chair. And I remember this poem was the first poem I read in that chair that was falling apart. My space in the house I shared, in the life I shared. And this poem spoke to me. No, it held me. No. Me abrazó. Someone else knew, understood, honored, validated, and forgave a violence I knew about, a violence I had hidden for so long. A short poem, 26 words, but a poem that saved me from having fear. Not just fear of the belt that repeatedly hit me in my past at one point, but the memory of it still lapping at my back. Martin Espada's work is well-crafted and well-received. He is one of the few Latinos to receive a Guggenheim Fellowship, a huge honor. His work has won the Patterson Award for Sustained Literary Achievement and an American Book Award. His work is musical, universal, celebrated. His last book, Republic of Poetry, was a finalist for the Pulitzer Prize. And his work is broad. He has 17 books to his name. Two are forthcoming that you need to be out on the look for. The Lover of a Subversive is also a subversive by the University of Michigan Press. And The Trouble Ball, which will be out in 2011 with Norton. But more than any accolade or prize, Martin Espada's work is real. It tells the truth. It is honest. It is único. And it saves. Saves stories from the dust of 9/11. Saves the history of Latino activism in the Americas. Saves the names of our poets, our singers, our congueros. But most of all, it saves us from keeping ourselves hidden, quiet, and forgotten. Please join me in welcoming Martin Espada.